Hey everyone, so welcome to the session 9 on the course Ordinary Differential Equation. So today we are going to talk about second and higher order differential equations. And once we see what are this differential equation, we will talk about a very nice theorem which is also called as the superposition or linearity principle. I will also tell you a couple of points where one has to be a bit cautious while seeing this theorem. So we'll see the outline of the proof and a couple of counterexamples. Then we will see what do you mean by an initial value problem, and then we will talk about the basis of a solution space. What is this solution space? I will come to it, and we will see this via linear algebra route. Okay, so if you don't know linear algebra, don't worry, I will keep the thing simple, and if you already know, it's a good thing, you will revise everything. So we will see this via linear algebra, and at the end we will see what do you mean by a general solution. So this is what the agenda is for today's class. It will be a bit theoretical. I won't be taking much examples today, but this is the building block to study second and higher order differential equations. So this thing should be clear. Otherwise, it will be difficult for you to understand coming lectures. So let's see what do you mean by second and higher order linear differential equations. So when do you call a second order differential equation is a linear differential equation? So whenever you see a differential equation of this form, y double dash plus p of x, some function of x into y dash, plus q of x, some function of x into y equal to r of x. So whenever you see differential equation in this form, we will call it as a second order linear differential equation. So if you recall my session 6th on linear differential equation, then I told you when you call something to be a linear, if the degree of the dependent variables should be 1, and there should not be the product of the dependent variable and its derivatives. So here if you see, the degree of the dependent variable and its derivatives is 1. Moreover, there is no product of the dependent variable and the derivatives. There is no y into y dash or y dash into y double dash. There is no such product. So whenever you have a differential equation of such a form, we call it to be a linear differential equation. So this is how a second order linear differential equation looks like. If your right hand side is 0, we call it as a homogeneous second order linear differential equation, and if the right hand side is non-zero, we call it as a non-homogeneous second order linear differential equation. And once you have the second order differential equation linear, the same thing, the same way one can generalize to higher order, and this is how it will look like for a third order linear differential equation. So whenever you have a third order linear differential equation, all the degrees of the dependent variable and its derivatives have degree 1. There is no product of the dependent variable and its derivative. And again the same thing. 0 then homogeneous, non-zero means non-homogeneous. And similarly one can generalize to nth order linear differential equation. So it will be of the form nth derivative of y. Open bracket means that represents the nth derivative. If you only write y raised to n, that means it is the composition of y n times. Okay, so it's a power of n. So bracket means you are taking its derivative. So your nth derivative of y plus some function of x into n minus 1th derivative plus some function of x into n minus 2 derivative plus some function of x into y equal to r of x. So this is how your nth order linear differential equation will look like. Again the same thing, if it is 0, homogeneous, non-zero, then non-homogeneous. And always make sure, we always keep the leading coefficient as 1. If it is not 1, you divide and then you take your p, q and h and whatever the coefficients are. So make sure you keep the coefficients as 1. So this is how one can define any nth order linear differential equation, homogeneous and non-homogeneous. Okay, now here p, q, these coefficients which are functions of x, they can be any functions of x, but for our course we will restrict it to continuous functions of x. Why continuous we need? We will see. Because why do we need continuity? Because at many places we will be doing the integration of this coefficients, and then the question is why the integration exists. And because if we assume continuity, we are assured that yeah, thanks to Riemann theory, integration of a continuous function always exists. So we will restrict ourselves to the continuous functions of x in all the scenarios. Okay, so let's see some examples so that the funda will be clear. So if you observe the first one, as you can see, this is a second order differential equation because the highest derivative is 2, and here there is the degree of the dependent variable and its derivative is 1, and right hand side we have a 0. That means we don't have a term which is independent of y and its derivative. So therefore this is a homogeneous and it's a linear as well. So this is linear as well as homogeneous. For the second case, it's a second order. Moreover, it's linear once again because the degree of the dependent variable and its derivative is 1. Therefore, it's linear. Moreover, your right hand side has a term, or you have a term which do not involve the dependent variable or the derivative, which we call R of x. So since it involves that term, so this is non-homogeneous, whereas this is linear. Now this is a third order differential equation. As you can see, it is homogeneous because there is no term which is independent of the dependent variable and its derivatives. That means we do not have R of x. And here we have a product, so it's homogeneous, whereas we have a product of the dependent variable and the derivative. So since we have this product, therefore this is a non-linear differential equation. Now this is a fifth order differential equation. Here, as you can see, we have a term that does not involve the dependent variable and its derivative. That means we have R of x, therefore this is non-homogeneous. Is this linear? Yes. The degree of the dependent variable and its derivative is 1, therefore this is a linear differential equation. And suppose if I take y prime square plus 7y equal to 7. Now is this homogeneous? No, because we have a term R of x, so this is non-homogeneous. Is this linear? No, the degree of y dash is 2, therefore degree is 2, so therefore this is not even a linear differential equation. So this is how one can classify differential equations as linear and homogeneous. So I hope these examples are clear. Okay, now let's jump towards the superposition principle. So this is what your superposition principle or the linearity principle says. It says if you have a second order linear and homogeneous differential equation, both the things are important. Even if one of the conditions gets violated, then the theorem is not true. I will take an example once the proof is done. So if you have a second order linear homogeneous differential equation, and if you take any two solutions of this differential equation, that means if you replace your y by y1 and y by y2, both y1 and y2 satisfies this equation 1. So if these are the solutions, then you take its any linear combination. What is c1 y1 plus c2 y2? It is the linear combination of these two functions. What are c1 c2? They are constants. So if you take any linear combination of y1 and y2, then it also forms the solution. So the theorem says linear combination of solution is again a solution for second order linear and homogeneous differential equation. Okay, so let's see the proof. So proof is quite simple. You simply substitute this in this differential equation and see whether you are getting 0 or not. I mean, whether c1 y1 plus c2 y2 is satisfying this differential equation or not. It's easy. You just replace y by c1 y1 plus c2 y2 everywhere. Now this double derivative will come inside. This is nothing but d2 by dx square, means double derivative. So this is nothing but c1 y1 double prime plus c2 y2 double prime. Why this is so? Because in linear algebra you have seen that derivative is a linear operator. What do you mean by linear operator? T of x plus y is tx plus ty, and t of some c into x is what? C into t of x. Then we say t is a linear operator. So your derivative is always a linear operator, and therefore this double derivative comes inside. That's the language of linear algebra I'm using. Again, here single derivative will come inside, and now when you combine, you take out c1 outside from here, here and here, you will have this part. You take out c2 outside from here, here and here, you get this part. Now this part is 0. Why? Because your y1 is a solution. That means your y1 will satisfy this differential equation. So this is c1 into 0 plus c2 into 0 again. Why? Because y2 is a solution of that differential equation, and therefore this is nothing but 0. Therefore if y1 and y2 are the solutions, then its linear combination is also a solution. So this is what the linearity principle says. Now if you observe nicely, what we are using? We are using that derivative is a linear operator and y1 and y2 are the solutions. So there is nothing special about second order differential equation. Even if you take a third order linear homogeneous differential equation, and if you have y1, y2 and y3 as the solution, then c1 y1 plus c2 y2 plus c3 y3 will also be a solution. And in general, if you have nth order linear homogeneous differential equations, and if you have y1, y2, y3 up to yn, if you have these n solutions, then if you take its linear combination, then that will also form a solution. So what I want to say is this. Now here, this is my nth order. This was for the third order, which I already said. You can go through this. And if you have nth order, linear, homogeneous, differential equation. And if these are the solutions, then its linear combination is also a solution. You can try for third order if you are not comfortable with nth order. And once you are done with third order, try to prove for nth order. Or you can directly jump for the nth order. And if you are getting stuck, you can ask me in the comment section. Okay, while saying this proof, I stressed on two words, linear and homogeneous. And if I said if any of the two conditions are violated, then the theorem is not true. So I should give a counterexample to support my argument, right? So here are the two examples where the theorem is not true. So let's take them one by one. So this is the counterexample one. If you observe here, homogeneous, this condition is violated. It's a second order, it's linear. But right hand side is non-zero. So therefore this is a second order linear non-homogeneous differential equation. Now one can verify that y1 and y2 are the solutions. Just find y1 double dash, substitute the value, it will satisfy this differential equation. Similarly y2 will satisfy this differential equation. Make sure you verify. So these are the two solutions of this differential equation. Now if you take y1 minus y2, which will be nothing but cos x minus sin x, and if you put that over here, that won't satisfy this differential equation. So therefore if I have two solutions, then its linear combination need not be a solution. So therefore homogeneous is required. Now suppose if you take a homogeneous, but if you violate the linearity condition, so if you can say this is homogeneous second order, but this is a non-linear. Why so? Because you can see there is a product of the dependent variable and the derivative. So therefore this is a non-linear homogeneous second order differential equation. One can verify that y of x is a solution. You simply find y dash and y double dash, plug in over here, it will satisfy this differential equation. But if you take a scalar multiplication, for example, if you take minus y of x, which is nothing but x square, then you can observe that if you put this over here, you find its derivative and double derivative, you plug in over here, then it's not a solution. So therefore, if you have a non-linear homogeneous second order differential equation, then if you take a linear combination, well, it's kind of combination only, I'm taking a scalar multiple. So even if you take a scalar multiple, then it is not a solution. So therefore, linear combination of a solution is a solution provided if it is a linear and homogeneous differential equation. So I hope both the examples are clear. Any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section.